response than I deserve. And I can see there is wisdom in your words. You continue to be there for me, don't you? Even after I keep pushing you away, you're still around when I need you most. You're like no man I've known before. And you're nothing like what I expected you to be after the Council sent us on this mission together. I need time to think about all this. Things have... they're not going as I thought they would. We should continue on with our mission. I should be able to control myself better than this. But you're not like anything I expected. You're not like any man I've ever met before. I find myself watching you when I don't need to. I'm thinking about you when I don't want to. It isn't supposed to be like this. Every time I try to call on all my teachings to calm myself, they fail me. You have such power, such passion. I don't know if it's due to the bond between us, but I'm drawn to you. The Force is a part of you, as is your power. But that's not what attracted me to you. It's more than that. Maybe it's the bond we share. It gives us a certain intimacy. If I could, I would return to Dantooine. I need to be away from this bond of ours. I need to weaken it. I need to be anywhere but near you. But Malak must be stopped. My own feelings are nothing when compared to that. Yet I know this could affect the sake of our mission if it's not resolved. I can't let that happen. What I've been trying to tell you is that I've reached a decision, but this is not the proper place for this discussion. I think we should have some privacy for this. We can talk about this the next time we return to the Ebon. I promised you an answer when we reached the Ebon Hawk, didn't I? But I'm afraid you won't like it. We should have some privacy for this. You're stronger than I am, and there's no point in telling me otherwise. You will be a great Jedi, I think. I hope. In some ways, you make me feel weak. Caught up in the wake of our destiny, but at the same time, you make me feel stronger, more alive. I realize now these feelings are part of the bond we share. The Jedi Council surely realized this. They knew my loyalty to the doctrines of our order would be tested on this mission. By facing and overcoming my feelings for you, I've learned a valuable lesson about control and the dangers of emotion. This is an important step in understanding the Force. I'm sorry if this is not what you wanted to hear, but I felt that it was important you know our infatuation was nothing more than a result of our powerful bond. You're the one who can't face the truth. Malak has to be stopped. How can I do that if I let myself be blinded by my feelings for you? You mean it, don't you? But how can I be sure you're not making a mistake? I have to resist. I have to be strong for both of us. But I don't... I mean, I can't. Malak will... Okay, you've made your point. Now shut up and kiss me, you fool. We shouldn't have done that. It was wrong. The Jedi are not allowed to fall in love. It was a moment of weakness when I kissed you. We shouldn't have. I'm sorry. No. I know we both wanted it, but we shouldn't have given in to our desire. We're Jedi. We can't act like this. Not now. Not while we still have to deal with Malak. I'm sorry. I don't blame you, but it was a mistake. I have to get out of here before somebody sees us together.